going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's me, Mikey Pipes. Ah, what a great day. Today is Wednesday, January 11th, 2023. And even though this video is not going to get posted for quite some time, because I need to save content for I'm away on vacation for 10 days. Mm-hmm. Today is a very special day, Peter. You know why?
Why is that? Want to take a guess?
It's 4 months since September 11th.
Oh.
Yep. It's been 4 months since September 11th. September 11th was the day of my last cigarette. On this quitting thing.
Yeah.
4 months.
That's pretty sweet.
It's very good, actually.
It's not easy.
It's not easy. Let me tell you something. Yesterday, I went to my kid's apartment, you know, my married son's apartment in Manhattan. And he, you know, him and his wife made us dinner. We finished a half bottle of Glenlivet 12, which is a single malt scotch.
Sounds expensive.
No, it's like maybe $50, $60 for a bottle. Okay. No, again, he's in law school. You know, he's really, you know, his wife is the, you know, is bringing home the bacon right now, bringing home the cheddar, right? But you know, we had a great time, had dessert and everything. Made some tuna steaks. He made some penne vodka with spaghetti, fresh homemade garlic bread. I wish I had a picture of it. I should have done a Mikey Pipes Uncensored there, but...
Mikey Pipes Eats.
Mikey Pipes Eats. Yeah, well, let's say baby steps one step at a time. But, I want you guys to check out the Mikey Pipes Philanthropy YouTube channel, all right? I just set up a 501c3 charity where we're going to give back. We're going to give back like no other YouTuber out there that does trade work like we do. Not that I'm aware of, at least, right? Not that I'm aware of. I set up an organization, a charitable organization, where Pipe Doctor is taking 2% of our gross receipts and setting it up into a charitable trust, right? And we're going to use that money, as amongst other things, right? Like ad revenue from the YouTube channel for the philanthropy website, donations from sponsors like manufacturers and Delta Force manufacturers, you know, things like that, right? And we're doing a great deed, but we're also going to be able to give them, you know, a charitable deduction, a tax write-off, right? But we're really going to give people in need, you know, basic necessities. And the basic necessities are functional plumbing and heating. I mean, if you don't have that in your home and you can't afford it, regardless of where you are, you need to reach out to me, mikeypipes.com. Let's make some moves together, right? And let's make the trades great again. You're listening to me, all you guys out there? And if you're interested in setting it up, maybe a recurring monthly donation, kind of like the ASPCA or the World Wildlife Federation, right? For your donation, $1 a day, we can like fix things, or, you know, with people who really can't afford it. I'm putting my money where my mouth is. You should do it too. Check it out, Mikey Pipes Philanthropy YouTube channel. Details in the description box below and also right there.
The service call is no heat on first floor and basement. I got money on steam without even knowing any history. You got money on hydronic?
Yeah.
Okay, rock, paper, scissors. 1, 2, 3, shoot. See, cheat. Ready? Rocks, play, play, play.
So I won.
You won?
Yeah.
All right, let's see. Let's look in the history. Pilot not lit.
Imagine that's what it is.
Actually, it says pilot not lit again in our ServicePal invoicing and dispatching app. That doesn't really tell us much. That doesn't really tell us much because that was a recall. And before that was February 25th, 2020. Let's see what that says. All right. No heat, first floor and basement?
Yes. Yeah, okay. Upstairs is good.
Let's see the boiler.
You want to go down to the boiler, right?
Yeah. So we should have went the side door?
The side door first, yes.
Where's the thermostat? Is it one thermostat for this floor, one thermostat downstairs?
Yeah.
Thermostat. Oh, yeah, baseboard.
Yes.
No steam? No steam heat?
No.
You had steam heat at one point in this house.
They must have converted.
Yeah. Peter, you won.
You won.
Hello, hello, hello. All right. Any Latina chicas? No.
Okay. They're hiding.
They're hiding. Let's see. I'm gonna be up behind 62 down here. Nope, that's the closet.
I mean, you might
be right. Want some donuts? Okay. Am I going the right way? I guess so. No, I can't be going the right way. Am I really going the right way? Yeah, I am.
Yeah, it's right here.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Peter.
It was
Peter, you're kind of half right, but I'm half right too. It's a steam boiler that converts to hot water. Okay. When they, Peter, check this out. Talk about an insulating blanket. Someone actually put a blanket on it. Wow, it's epic, by the way. All right, your first floor zone valve, I can tell you right now, is kaput.
Okay.
That's definitely bad 100%. Okay. It's not doing anything. You probably have an end switch issue, but we'll figure that out next. The basement. Hey, Peter, when we you turn that, flip that light on right there.
This one?
No, yeah, right no, there. Look.
Yeah, both of them.
And that right there.
And that one above, yeah.
On the first day, God said, let there be light, and the bulb was dead. You see, that's where the sight glass was from here to there. See? I was right. Steam boiler, repurposed. I hear something. Huh? That's circulating. That's hot. Okay. First, second, it's gotta be basement. You turn the basement zone on? All right. Wow, this thing really needs some service. Wow. There's a combustion analysis that we did years ago.
Actually, she's getting heat down here.
I know, it works.
Yeah, so it's just...
Yeah, at the first floor.
Okay.
Yeah. All right, we need a new zone valve. See, Peter, I would rip all this stuff out right here. All of it out. Give me like, I don't know, 20, 30K. You make another bedroom down here? That's another $800 a month in rent.
We'll make that money.
All right, I'm not saying this is, you know, totally a legitimate legal basement, you know, basement apartment, but with an egress window. But I'll put a bedroom right here in the middle of it, right in the middle of the basement. I'll put four people here, two bunk beds. Yeah, you know what?
I'll live here.
Yeah, I'll charge $200 a week for each one. All right, 2, 4, 6, 8. That's $800 a week times four. That's $3,200. Right. $3,200 for just one more room.
I'll make his money back.
Right, I'll even put a urinal in here too. I swear. Oh, by the way, is this, we got a straightening iron there. Oh.
Latina
Chicas. All right, here. You got to take that apart.
Yeah.
This is a zone valve we're changing. If you look, see, it's all fucked. See, it's broken. And I did promise myself the next one we work on, we're going to clean up all the wiring. But Peter, let's do it the next one after this one. Because to put this in a junction box with the little offsets, make it look nice and pretty, not today. But this has got to get taken care of. All right. So we have a screw here, and there's a one right on the opposite side right there. All right. We're going to take those two screws out. This whole zone valve, which is hot as can be, hot like fire. Ow!
She's hot.
Oh. All right, Peter is taking out the two screws.
Yep.
Oh, under pressure. Don't be under pressure, Peter. You got this. You got this.
I'll take it. Bring it on this side. We'll show them.
See the screw right there? Oh, where is it? Oh. Oh, come on. Get in there. Right there. Okay. So... Well, you took the other screw out. Now this one is out. You notice, pull this head off. It's still active, by the way, even though the switch is off. Just pop it off. Come on. There you go. Now, on older models, this little thing right here, right? These aren't there. When you take the screw out, the thing starts leaking water. So keep that in mind. Okay.
You know, I'm like, why is this so bad? I was ready to go buy a cheaper thermostat. I said, you know what? There's probably something to do.
Yeah, good call.
The thermostat was giving me all the readings that it was working.
Okay. Yep. Hit that screw in right there.
Yep.
Yeah, the thermostat was working. Problem is the zone valve was internally broken. It's an electronic valve. So it like open and close. Instead of having a lever, it does it with a motor.
Okay.
Right? And inside there's these springs and levers and mechanisms that... open up the valve inside when it gets power, and once it knows it's open, it tells the boiler to turn on. So in your case, it was just running. There you go, and not doing anything. Okay. once that is in, that zone valve will have lose its resistance. All right?
Mm-hmm. Show them the valve lever. It's on that side, right?
Yeah.
Did it hit the end switch yet?
I think I just heard the end switch, yeah. Just trying to focus. Yeah, I just heard a click before.
Good. Okay. Let's see what the temperatures are, or the boiler is.
Okay.
There's a temperature and pressure gauge.
No. We're at 150. Here's an Aquastat relay. Pulled in. All right, there's our thermostats. Those are the end switches. And
is that normal?
What? Yeah, it's an old Aquastat. This circulator is on. I can tell you that right now. That's hot. All right.
You didn't. Oh, there it is. It's on the other side. The end switch.
You said I'm on the wrong side. See the end switch. Let's get in there. Come on. There's the end switch, right? There. You can't see it. It's right there. See a little silver tab right there? That's the end switch. Right there. Let's take off the yellow wire. Right? See it move? Boom. If you look dead center. There's a little black button there. Plug in those two wires again.
Yep.
And watch. It's gonna get power. Okay. Here comes the lever. Here it comes. There it is. And it pushes in the little. There it is. The little click that you heard. Okay. That was the end switch close. That's why I said
that. Why is it not working?
The boiler switch is off.
Oh. Oh. Well, that explains a lot. So here's a little more side information here, right? Mm-hmm. First floor, mm-hmm. Second floor, basement, right? We had him turn off because the original complaint was the first floor and the basement zones don't heat. Mm-hmm. But when we got here, the thermostat was set for 62. It was reading 62. But also the second floor zone was on, mm-hmm. right? Now it's off because I had him turn off the first floor and second floor thermostats. And see this? How I have no resistance, which means it's actively calling, right? Mm-hmm. I am going to manually force open quickly the lever here. When I quickly push this lever in, right, it's that lever is going to hit the end switch. And if the boiler clicks on, the relay clicks on, we know that the end switch on this is shot. Watch this.
Oh, that's true.
All right, here we go. Heard that? Yeah. The end switch on the basement zone is shot. So the only way the basement will have hot water flowing through it mm-hmm. is if the first floor, second floor zone is on. The only way to resolve this is to change out the zone valve. All right, perfect example of why I put off tomorrow what we could do for today. We're going to change this zone valve relay. Okay. So first thing we're going to do is make sure we don't step on any glue traps. Now... Perfect. Okay, we need that flat screwdriver that we were using before.
Yeah.
You want to do it or want me to do it?
I can change the face.
Okay.
Facing me, doesn't have any windows or like, sometimes, you know, they build these forever homes.
I know.
There's nothing for him to
cop it to. No, but the fact that he elevated the whole property.
Right.
It's, I don't know how the neighbors let that go down like that, but. I guess it is. I guess it helps your value, though. Right?
I don't know, because, we, you know, it's not really...
Well, but if it ever sells, yeah.
Like, oh, yeah, if it does ever sell.
Yeah.
I didn't even realize... I didn't, you know, put any thought into if they did raise it. But it, obviously, that you mentioned it now, yeah, it is. When we first... I think when we... it started about 3 years ago. Project.
What's the matter, Peter? You hold the flashlight for you?
Just the screws. Just gotta fall out.
The screw's not gonna fall out. You gotta slam it in there and then it twists it and turns a little bit and it'll pop in.
It's the only one way of doing it. Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. You heard it snap into place?
A little bit, yeah.
Okay. So now screw it in. All right. That one and the other one. It's not a pain if it snaps in place. It's right in line where it needs to go. Okay, undo the lever. It should move freely. Okay, now we're gonna wire it.
All right, so I forgot to record an outro for the zone valve replacements. Multiple zone valve replacements, but after leaving this job, I had to go help out Frankie because his iPad wasn't connected to the cellular network, and we pull up to the house and see this.
I gotta tell you, it looks like a cleaner truck, even though Mike's not driving it. Because Mike's not driving it. Frankie is on his first day by himself because Mike wasn't feeling well this morning, the other Mike, and we had a few stoppages that were unscheduled that I figured, you know what, let's throw him to the wolves, and he did it.
Not cleaning up already, but there's a guy who loves me.
Yeah.
And he only wants me there, but we're going to go say hi. We'll go check in on Frankie. And hope you enjoyed this video. Listen, Peter got his hands wet a little bit, you know, get a little dirty, getting some zone valves changed out in that filthy basement.
Yeah.
But we signed him up for a maintenance plan. You know, it's called recurring revenue. On a monthly basis, like a... just like keep going on like this.
Passive income.
Look at this. Wow, blew me away. Passive income, that's correct. And listen, that's how you build value with a company and also build value with your consumers, your customers, your clients, right? Getting it done. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Be well, God bless, stay safe.
Where's all this water coming from? No, the water in the crawl space.
What's up, Paul?
What's up, Frankie?
What's going on?
Boy, I got the mask on and everything. Legit.
Getting up?
Wow! Help him out, Peter. I got Peter to help you.
Peter,
give me a hand. Hold on. Give me a hand. Clap. There you go. Now, guys, spin around the other way. Don't forget, don't lose the air switch. There it is. Getting it done. You know what? We're gonna give Frankie a GoPro. We're gonna make him some. We're gonna give him a YouTube channel. I'm not gonna be the only one. You right there, Frankie?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, my boy Frankie. Yeah.
What's going on?
What's going on?
I made it.
You made it. Should we do water jetting here? I'm not saying we're gonna do it today, but
yeah.
Okay. All right. It's a little after 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Frankie had 3 service calls today. We had a preventative mainline stoppage. We had a dishwasher tailpiece, same job. We had a shower stoppage and we had a mainline stoppage. And not bad. Did a great job. Most importantly, the customers love them. You know, you gotta be personable in the work that we do. Gotta have that bedside manner, and Frankie's fitting in just perfect. All right, guys, thank you so much for tuning in. Until next time, be well, God bless, and stay safe.